I welcome you all in the Remedial Biology. So in this video tutorial, we are going to see, as some of the topics, some of the students have requested me to take the theory part also. So some of the topics I will cover of the theory part of the Remedial Biology of the unit number 1. So far we have covered, if you see, we have covered the morphology of the flowering plants. And there is one topic left in this, that is about the monocot and dicot. So in this video tutorial, we are going to cover what are the monocot and dicot. Okay, so first of all, let's see about the plant kingdom. Don't worry, we will do this again in the upcoming videos. So if we divide plant kingdom generally into two categories, that is the cryptogamy, or you can say spore bearing plants. And these are phanerogamy, seed bearing plant, they have seed. Okay, and the spore bearing plants like thallophyta, apne ferns dekhe, fern, I will show you the figure. What is this? This is a fern. Ab aim kya hai? Nature ka aim kya hai? What is the aim of the life? Fertilization. Okay, so how it will fertilize? It has no flowers. So no pollination. How it is this possible? So when I write here, spores. So you will see it fertilized by using spores. So aapne sabhi ne ye plant dekha bhi hoga apne aas paas. This is a fern. So it is a spore bearing plant. So here it is. What is this phanerogamy means? Spore bearing plant like thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta. Don't worry, I will cover this in detail in some other video. But over here, we will focus upon the monocot and dicot. So in the plant kingdom, when we see about the seed bearing plant, there are two types. Gymnosperms and angiosperms. If we talk about the gymnosperms, so that means G-Y-M-N-O, gymnosperms. So just they have seed, but this is naked seed. This is naked seed because these are known flowering plants. Okay, these are known flowering plants. Whereas in the angiosperm, we have flower and then they produce the seed. So seeds are basically enclosed inside your fruit. In angiosperm, seeds are enclosed inside your fruit. Whereas gymnosperms, it is naked seed. So angiosperm divided into again two, monocot and dicot. So don't worry, we will again cover this in the upcoming videos. So over here, our aim to cover this topic, monocot and dicot. So I'm starting here, plant kingdom, then seed bearing plants, angiosperm, that is flowering plants, two types, monocot and dicot. So let's start. So this will clear you all your doubts. So there are two types of plant, monocots and dicots. So the monocot plants means one cotyledon. So I hope you remember about the cotyledon because we have somewhat covered in the seed part. So monocot plant has these type of characteristics. Means they have seed, root, stem, leaf and flower characteristics. And they are different from the dicot one. So first of all, we will cover the seed. In monocot, only one seed, that is the one cotyledon only, one seeded cotyledon. Okay, that's why there are monocot, and where in dicot there are two cotyledons. See again, monocot only one cotyledon. Okay, where in the dicot there are one, this cotyledon one, this is second cotyledon. But over here this is only one cotyledon is present. Second part, if you talk about the root, or we can say, don't worry, we will talk about leaf now. First is the seed part, I think this is clear, then we will focus upon the leaf. In the monocot, leaf have parallel venation. Parallel venation. I hope you remember about the venation. We have already covered. Whereas the dicot, they have reticulate or net-like venation. Please see this image. So this is your monocot plant. Why? Because in this venation are parallel to each other. What is veins? These are the veins. And in this monocot, the veins are parallel to each other. Whereas in the dicot plant, they are net-like. These veins are arranged in the form of net. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Again, see this image. This is a monocot leaf, parallel veins. This is dicot leaf, net-like veins. Again, see this. This is again monocot, parallel venations, and dicot, net-like venation. So this is monocot, parallel, dicot, net-like. So if we see the third difference, now I think this is clear, seed and leaf. Third is the flower. In the monocot, flower parts in the three or multiple of the three. Look at this. This florets. 1, 2, 3. Chatar monocots may we found this is 3 or multiple of 3. Whereas in dicot, we have flower parts 4 or 5 and their multiples. Please see this image. Monocot flower again 1, 2, 3. Whereas in dicot, parts in 4 or 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And monocots only 1, 2 and 3. So this is the major difference in the flower part. So I think this is clear. Seed is clear. Leaf and flower. Now we'll talk about the microscopic difference. If we talk about the microscopy of the root, transverse section of the root or stem, so what are the difference in the microscopic we observe? In case of monocot, if we cut the TS of the root, transverse section of the root xylem and phloem are arranged in the ring. I hope you remember about xylem and phloem. So xylem is basically required for the transportation of water, and phloem is required for the transportation of the food. Okay, phloem food, can easily write, remember this, phloem food. So what it says, root xylem and phloem are arranged in a ring in the monocot. As you can see this image, so xylem and phloem, which is present in the root, they are arranged in the ring form. So this is xylem and phloem, they are present in the ring. I'm showing you the figure. Okay, see this one. So this is dicot versus monocot. This is monocot. Xylem and phloem are arranged in the ring form. Okay. You can see here, this is the monocot root. So where is xylem and the phloem? Basically, xylem and phloem are the plant tissues. Okay. Don't worry, we will cover that also. This is xylem and this is phloem. So this is arranged in the ring form. Okay. Just remember this thing for a time being. Please remember this. These are present in the ring form in case of monocot root. Okay. And in case of dicot, the phloem and the xylem, they are basically arranged in different way. Or you can say that they are scattered. Just read this. In dicot, the vascular structures are located in the middle of the root. And the arrangement of the xylem phloem is different in dicot than in the monocot. The xylem is located in the middle of the dicot root, and the bundles of phloems are arranged around it. If you see this representation of the dicot root, so here I will zoom you. For you, I will zoom this. Yes, here you can see this is the phloem. This part is the phloem, and this is your xylem, or you can say metaxylem is also sub part of xylem. So this is your, suppose, xylem, and this is phloem. How it is arranged? So the xylem is located in the middle of the dicot root. Yes, xylem is located in the middle of the dicot root. And the bundle of the phloem are arranged around it. And the bundle of the phloem are arranged around it. Okay, again, this is a phloem. The bundle of the phloem are arranged around it, and the xylem is located in the middle. This is the arrangement of the dicot root. Last difference, but not the least. If we talk about the stem, in the monocot, again, the vascular bundles are there. The vascular bundles are scattered in the stem. They are scattered all over. Whereas in dicot, vascular bundles are arranged in the form of ring, just like vice versa. Here you can see, just here in the root. Root mein kya tha? Monocots mein, ek ring ki form mein. Now, over here in the dicots again, in the form of ring, but in which part? In the stem part. So you will remember this difference. In the monocot stem, vascular bundles are scattered. Whereas in the dicot stem, vascular bundles are arranged in the form of ring. So I hope this will give you a brief idea about the monocot and dicot. And in the last, I acknowledge all the sources I have used to prepare this video. So we have completed this point. That's it, is the monocot and dicot. I think this is clear to you now. Okay, so see you in the next video tutorial. Thank you for your patience and listening.